In today's video, we're gonna see what happens if we take two popular fast food meals and pull all of the moisture out of them. What's gonna be left?
Guys, we have a new freeze dryer, and you have seen us do at least one really weird thing with it so far. We have freeze dried steak, but we want to take it to the next level. That was just one thing. So now we're going to try an entire meal from two different places and see what happens.
Here's the basic idea. We'll get a meal from Wendy's, including a Frosty, and a meal from Panda Express. We'll throw them both in the freeze dryer and let it run for about 48 hours to really remove every drop of moisture. We've all had fast food and we know what they're like, but we are curious to see what's gonna happen if we extract all of the moisture from an entire meal, and not just like a burger. We're talking the burger, the fries, the shake, and the drinks on the side. Like, what are those gonna do?
The orange chicken, the chow mein, the fried rice. Let's do it.
All of it. We wanna try it. So, we've got our freeze dryer, so next step, we need some food. Let's go with a junior bacon cheeseburger, a medium french fries, and a small chocolate frosty.
Is that it on the first order?
Yeah, that's all one order. We've got fried rice, chow mein noodles, orange chicken, beef and broccoli. With that, we've got a cup of Pepsi with some ice still in it. We've got a Wendy's frosty, a junior bacon cheeseburger. Bacon's somewhere on there. There you go. That's got lettuce and tomato and mayo as well. And then we've got some french fries. All right, now it freezes.
So is this what we're gonna do for just like the next 48 hours?
Yeah.
It's been 2 days of freeze drying, so I think our food is about as dried out as it's gonna get. Now I wanna see what happened to it. We can see that something definitely happened. We had a Frosty in there, and now we have an explosion of frosty foam all over everything.
And some soda, a little bit of soda in
soda,
there.
Soda, I think, has also escaped the confines of its container.
We got a side-by-side meal here.
To compare the before and after.
Yeah, exactly the same meals.
Got a laptop with the footage uploaded from our GoPros. It goes pretty fast. That, whoa. nothing.
Boom.
Gone.
Wait, what's the other one look like? Nothing. You can kind of see a little bit of change.
The lettuce is there, and then just a lot the frosty and a little bit the soda.
You can kind of watch the okay, there it is, right there.
Wow. Holy cow, that escaped its container. Oh, and look at the mayo on the burger.
Scrub
for just a little bit. There you go. The mayo is inflating the same way as the frosty. You can see our soda is starting to bubble up as well. Not as much as our frosty. Not even close. That is just everywhere, and it does look like it also got on our Panda Express food in the back, so
we may
have to dig through some frosty to find the Panda Express food. Let's open it up.
Oh no, it really is all over.
Oh, and it's cold.
Just
trying to see if there's any smell. Ice melting off the sides.
Uh-huh.
So there's more smell down
here. Is there supposed to be this much ice everywhere?
That's pretty normal.
Okay.
Yeah. In fact, I think there used to be more ice there.
Wow.
And then some of it sublimates off as it vacuums.
You know what we have to do now.
It's too cold.
It's actually good.
Kind of is. Like, I like fries crispy. I usually ask for them to be cooked extra crispy. This is more extra crispy. This is crunchy. Whole tray out.
Cold. Oh no, our poor panda.
Very cold. That was in the frosty to start with.
The soda is pretty much just done for. That I like, that's
gummy.
Really good. Dehydrated soda starts out as a crunchy candy and then it goes gummy, kind of like a now and later, and it's so good.
And we've put soda in our regular dehydrator before. This is a fancier process. Similar result, not quite the same. All right, frosty. It's pretty good. If you've ever had astronaut ice cream, very similar to that, unsurprisingly.
I'm just wearing Frosty.
This is so light and puffy. Like this thing weighs less than a marshmallow. Yeah, we should definitely taste the individual ingredients here.
That still tastes just like lettuce,
just crunchier.
It's paper lettuce, but the fact that it still tastes like lettuce is bizarre.
We need to try some of this.
So this is freeze-dried beef and broccoli. Well, just the beef part. Regular. So this was bought about 20 minutes ago. Yeah, it's still really good. When we freeze-dried the steak, again, those were very, very thick, and we didn't really season them that much, so there wasn't a lot of flavor.
Almost none.
Now, of course, fast food is known for just having a ton of chemicals in it. This stuff, even though it's been freeze-dried, is still delicious.
How is it?
It still tastes good. Mm-hmm. I would eat these as chips. Just make straight vegetable chips.
I'm gonna cut our cheeseburger, our junior bacon cheeseburger in half. All right, here we can see bread, burger, bacon, cheese, lettuce, tomato, and I think there's some mayo on top of that, or there was. Well, this is cheese as much as fast food burgers have cheese on them. Completely freeze-dried. I'm gonna try dipping it in cool water and see if it comes back to life at all. Let that absorb for a bit. Here's our comparison of our not freeze-dried. So you can see most of the same pieces. The cheese is definitely a different texture.
Oh yeah. If I wasn't touching this, if I didn't know that it was crunchy, this actually looks more appetizing to me. That just looks slimy. Just looks fluffier.
Would you like a cup of water? there's some Pepsi behind you? How's that working out? I'm gonna see what happens if we put a freeze-dried French fry into some hot water. I don't know how long French fries should take to rehydrate. The inside is more of the normal French fry texture now. The outside, I don't think, has quite finished absorbing the water. The outside of a French fry is gonna have a lot of oil in it, so it may be repelling the water a little bit. So crunchy.
So far I would say that other than the Frosty, Panda is holding up better, I think.
Looks like that so far.
Yeah. Okay, let's add some chicken. Should we add some broccoli? Delicious. Let's see what that looks like in 10 minutes.
The freeze-dried noodles have a very styrofoam-like texture. It has a crunch and then like a...
Freeze-dried, reconstituted chow mein ramen with orange chicken and broccoli and beef. Okay. So we had to switch out the water because it got a little bit cold, and I think all of the flavor ended up in the water just like it would in like a ramen broth. That was a problem that we had when we freeze-dried our steak again. We lost all the flavor when we tried to reconstitute it, so. Yeah, basically the same problem.
Starting pretty small. That is not much water, and it's just sucking it down in. No mixing, no stirring, just dissolving it. All right, let's try this rehydrated frosting. Now, it's not gonna be frozen, because we weren't mixing it with frozen water. That's kind of hard to do, but let's give it a try. It's not bad.
It's chunkier than I like my Frosties.
Little tiny bits of the Frosty definitely aren't mixed in, so it tastes kind of like you made it from a powdered mix, which we basically did,
yeah. And
just didn't mix it quite enough. I'm gonna blend up a Wendy's meal into dust. Margarita. Soup. That is part of a junior bacon cheeseburger and several french fries.
Oh, might as well.
Spoonful of cheeseburger and french fry powder.
Yeah, I'm sticking to my panda. That's really weird because nobody's ever thought, what does a powdered cheeseburger look like? But that's probably what you would guess.
While I'm eating it, it doesn't really feel like I'm eating a cheeseburger. And maybe that's just because the texture is too different that I don't really notice that the flavors are similar or something like that. But I gotta say, what's a little strange is after I'm done eating, I'm just like, did I just eat a cheeseburger? Like, it feels like I ate a cheeseburger afterward. So it does have all the same flavors and components in there, of course. The experience is very different as you're doing it.
So weirdly enough, I would say that out of everything, the thing that reconstitutes best is the broccoli. This actually turned out pretty good. Guys, that's not all. We've always got more for you to see. This box up here at the top will take you to our latest video, and that box at the bottom is what YouTube thinks you should be watching next. Hit that bomb in the middle so you're subscribed to the club and you never miss out on the fun. Don't forget to ring that bell and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then.